Shanta Gold recently announced that your fundraising for your drilling project at the West Kenya project was significantly oversubscribed. We have Eric Zurrin with us just now to explain that and also how you're going to make all these shareholders will make it worthwhile for them, Eric.
Indeed, yes. Thanks, Katie, for having me. The news of the day for Shanta is a fundraising that we did last week. You're right, it was very oversubscribed. And in fact, because of the interest and demand, we were able to also clear a piece of overhang, perceived overhang. So Barrick is now, has been bought out, which is good news for us, because they were ultimately always going to do that anyway. And so we've institutionalized the share register. We have an incredible, interest from global investors. And really what we've done with this now, what we've said to we will do with this, these funds is to invest in the West Kenya project. Now, we were going to do that anyway, but this lets us do it much, much faster. And, you know, the way I think of it really is we've acquired this asset for $12 an ounce, you know, very attractive entry price, but we now need to demonstrate that it's probably worth closer to, we think, $200 or $300 an ounce. So worth a lot more than what we paid. And the only way to do that is to invest in it.
Eric, you've spoken in the past about the high grade potential. Do you want to maybe remind us of this?
Indeed, yeah. West Kenya is the highest grading plus 1 million ounce deposit in Africa. It's 1.2 million ounces at 12.6 grams per ton. That is an eye-catching grade. It's been heavily de-risked by Acacia. They spent $64 million on it. We paid 20 cents on the dollar. Mm-hmm. And this has, we think, so much potential. Now, just look at what Barrick announced last week. Barrick in Tanzania talk about 10 new exploration licenses that they're investing in. This is in the same belt. Don't forget, it's on the Kenyan side of the border, but these are highly attractive areas for mineral endowment, and that's where you want to start with. It always comes down to asset quality.
And when you say faster, how fast are we talking?
Well, just last week on Thursday, I had our head of exploration and one of his geologists in Mwanza, so in northern Tanzania, inspecting the rig that will start drilling next month. Now, the instruction is because now we have funding, we will put two rigs on the project next month. And the strategy that we've looked at scenarios is to actually increase that to three rigs starting next year. So when we think about faster, the difference between one rig and two rig is half the time. Mm-hmm. The difference between one rig and three rigs is obviously three times quicker.
And all of these people that invested, obviously, they're going to want to know when the results are going to come in, when they're going to be reaping their rewards. It's early days, but in terms of news flow, what can they expect?
Well, where we were 9 months ago, we basically had one asset generating all of our news flow, the New Luika gold mine. Mm-hmm. We now have three assets in two countries. Mm-hmm. As the drilling starts at West Kenya, that will be a natural piece of news flow. At Singida, our second asset in Tanzania, we're also looking at reserve increases. We'll be drilling there before the end of the year. We've now announced construction to start there as well. So that is very, very meaningful to our story because in not too long, in 2022, we will be a 110,000 ounce producer. Now, obviously at New Luika, which was the core asset for many, many years, mm-hmm. we have ongoing drilling. We've drilled there, I think we've drilled now 25,000 meters. We've more than replaced our mine life this year. So our mine ounces this year. And there's a lot to look forward to from that asset as well. So across the board, three assets, catalysts across all three. And that should start much before Christmas.
Eric Zurrin from Shanta Gold. Thank you very much indeed.